Hey, this is your Olympic hero, Kurt Angle. And you're watching Super Joe C from Stampede Gaming. And you know what? He has the three I's: intensity, integrity, and intelligence. And he doesn't suck. Oh, it's true. It's damn true.
What's going on? Captain Joe C here from Stampede Gaming. Welcome back to another challenge video. Today it's going to be Captain America and the Avengers on the NES. And today's challenge, we're going to be playing as Captain America only. And we're not going to be picking up any power upgrades whatsoever. So, by power upgrades, what I mean is that this game gives you like a gem system. Kind of like an RPG system where you keep leveling up. So after a certain amount of gems, you level up to the next level, which doesn't really tell you. All you can see is your health bar increase. And as your health bar increases, your power increases. What I'm going to try to do is... I mean, I can pick up some gems as long as I don't upgrade to the next... To the next upgrade spot. So right now, as you can see, I have 8 bars of life. 8 bars of power, sorry. And I think, I don't know, something like 100 gems or whatever you pick up, you move on to the next level and so forth until you max out to like, I think 20 bars for each one. So unfortunately, you can't pick and choose which one you want to upgrade. They both upgrade at the same time, which is probably great, I guess, right? But for a challenge like this, I would love to have more life, but I'm going to sacrifice that just to get the least power. So the whole point is we're going to try to beat this game with the fewest amount of power. And by doing that, we have to keep our life bar as it is. So it's going to be a pretty difficult challenge. Oh god. And Cap does have better moves than Hawkeye. Right there, you can see there, I did a charge there. He does like this like Kirby down arrow thing. You know how Kirby does in Smash Brothers when you hold like down? Ooh, got killed there. Oh crap, I need to get this. Oh no, that's, those are the gems. We don't want the gems. Where is this gem? You know what? I think it's back that way. Sorry, so we don't want the gem, but I'm trying to grab here is an exit orb. I think it's this one. There it is. You can't exit the level unless you grab one of these orbs. Or am I getting some health? Perfect. Who cares about that? It's fine. We really had to leave or to exit. So yeah, Captain America is actually stronger too than Hawkeye in this game. Hawkeye doesn't have those special abilities like Cap. All Hawkeye can do is shoot arrows, but he can shoot them in any direction pretty much. I gotta try to remember this now. Whoa. Good dodging skills there. So basically, one of these moves here, like the downward shield thing, one of those is equivalent to three shield smashes, or shield throws. Yeah, as you can see, Cap can hang on to those things, Hawkeye can't do that at all. So Cap is a little stronger, and he's Cap. Cap's the best. Okay, so, in the middle of the map area here, which is a map of America, as you can see, you're gonna get these little, like, black whirlwind things. Those are, like, sub-bosses. And some of them are pretty annoying. Like this guy here, this guy is super annoying. Oh, he's got hit there. Sometimes it'll be a 2-for-1, you'll get the other guy, his partner I call him. Dead. Might be his partner, yep. Try to make short work of this guy. And we barely got out of that one. Nice. Alright. And guess what? I'm not going to get a health upgrade here. Unless I clear this room. Exit. Whoa. There we go. And we got a boss fight now. I don't know who this boss is, but I'm gonna take my timing and play it safe. I wanna say it's Leader, but I'm not too sure. Like, there might be a faster way to beat him, but I'm just playing it safe. I mean, it's an alright game. The controls are really good. They're tight. One thing, though, I really don't like about it is that when you die, sometimes the checkpoints are good, sometimes, depending on where you die, sometimes the checkpoints are, like, really bad where you gotta redo a lot of stuff. So I really don't want to die. when the music starts to change, it means he's almost dead. Lights out for you. Those were light switches I was hitting there. So I think, I want to say it's leader, but I don't know. What? Alright, so. In that first area that we were at, that little diamond that I'm at the top of now. That was, I guess like the first section we'll call it, right? And from there, I only defeated one of those whirlpools, not both of them. But once you get past the boss, the other whirlpool just disappears. Now two more spawn, going to the next area, which is the top right corner, which is going to be New York. Now, after you beat a boss, all the enemies, they all power up. So yeah, you get your own power-ups by getting the gems, but all the enemies are going to power up and be stronger. So that's something to keep in mind as you keep progressing the game. Alright, so we're gonna go here. Don't know if I'm gonna make it through. Oh yeah. Oh crap. We made it somehow. Don't ask me how. Okay, so we're in Richmond now. I don't remember where the, oh, crap. Oh, we use a cheap way to beat this guy. So, once we die as Captain America, we have to take control of Hawkeye, we have no choice. But this is how we manipulate the game now. We're gonna use, now, so this is a Captain America only run, but we're only gonna use Hawkeye just to revive Captain America. And how you do that? It's so simple. In his opening level, you gotta get the, I don't even know what it's called, it's one of the icons. This one right here. You hear that noise and you return. When you return, you basically exit a level. You start back where you were and I can pick Cap again. Perfect. And now we're in Philadelphia. We don't have to go through them at all. So sometimes the spawning points will be in your favor, sometimes they won't be. So depending on how much I die here, you'll see me dying on purpose just to spawn at a proper area. We gotta take on one or more of these. This one's not too bad. Actually, you know what? The shield, oh yeah, the shield can do it. Nice. Alright, we're in New York, and I think at the end of this level is Ultron. Move.
Oh.
Okay, take your time here. Perfect. Oh yeah, okay. That's a perfect run right there. Alright, gotta take on Ultron now. Gotta concentrate. There's a specific way to beat him. And I missed it. I think we might be alright. Pattern. Okay, so as you can see, I spawned back all the way to the beginning. So what I'm gonna try to do now, we're gonna revive Captain America. Die with him on purpose, or we could go through the whole way, but I'd rather skip some stages here. And somehow I defeat him by doing nothing. Perfect. There you go. As you can see, it propelled me to where I was before. So now we'll just proceed with Hawkeye here. Philly. We'll be right back. Wait, one more shot at Ultron. What? This guy's changing up the pattern on me. Alright. Do the same thing over again. Every time he dies, Captain America, get used to the screen. So yeah, we're doing this just for positioning purposes. That's a nice block. Dude, what is this bullshit? It's all right. I could do this all day. try a different way. See if we can die a different way. Make it quicker. Ah. Ah, perfect. There's usually a set pattern I use on Ultron. For some reason, he's not following it. Could be just RNG, I guess. That time it works perfect. Look at that. Okay. We have moved on. Bottom. Nah, that thing won't come back. No! Not the bat, please. Oh, the bat. And I died. Okay, you see where they position me? It's actually a really good position right there. So, like before, the enemies get stronger now. But using this tactic here, you have like infinite chances with Captain America. Gotta go through one of these guys. And by the way, this is all like random, so if let's say I die here, I gotta go through these guys again, like what, on the whirlpool. The whirlpool is always gonna be random, but it's gonna be the same like set of guys. It could be this, it could be the other guys. Alright, this is where shit starts to get real. This guy's really annoying because he takes so many hits. And the other guy too, because he's hard to beat. Okay, so I'll tell you why this gets annoying now, because after I get past this part, so the boss in this level with Crossbones, after I beat him, I'd have to go through two more stages just to get to the Quinchet. If I don't make it there, I have to start all the way back from here, and it gets really annoying. So I really gotta step up my game here. Pretty much I gotta be perfect. My health at? I'll grab this piece over here. Alright, here, very important. Gotta tank the hit here. Beauty. Alright, now the exits will start having lasers on them. Just gotta be careful here. Try to charge right through it. Thank you. So he's dead. Crossbones in one shot. Alright, now I need to get through these next two stages. Yeah, and see all those whirlpools, whirlwinds, whatever things, they're all dead. I gotta get through these next two stages without dying. If I die, I gotta do the stage I just beat and the next two stages. It's basically three stages in a row. And it's not bad, but it's just annoying because the bosses are like really, really, really like tedious. Starting with this guy. Alright, I'm gonna take my time here. Time my shots. I mean, you could speed things up a little, but... I shouldn't. Should play it safe. Okay, so after that, now you gotta deal with these guys again. Just in case you need health. And these guys here, now that we beat the crossbones, like I said, every time you beat a boss, so it would be like, I think it was what, leader, ultra, now crossbones, enemy HP just goes up high. Thank you. Let's mess that up. So as you can see, it gets not hard, but it's just so tedious to have to do all that. See how slow that was, like both like sub bosses, or like the set of sub bosses we just fought, and then that mini boss whatever before that. And then trying to get this thing. Oh man. Just for the exit. I think we gotta destroy some more switches here. You go through this door and you come back out, and those enemies should be gone. Perfect. Okay. Careful here. Perfect. All right, so yeah, as you can see, the Quinchet is in Las Vegas. So one more stage, guys. If we get through this stage, we're clear sailing ahead. And of course, we gotta deal with the bullshit here. think I'm at full health. Perfect. Perfect. Now we got one more of those mini bosses that we fought before. Hold on. Right here. Here we're gonna take our time. We're so close to the end. I don't wanna mess this up. Time my shots here. I'm getting very impatient, but I gotta keep my composure. Keep my cool. Like, these parts are just so tedious. That's why I don't want to do these ever again. It's probably gonna hurt me and get this over with. I want to drop down here. I want to take a chance. Maybe the last enemy I gotta hit. We'll wait it out. Yeah, I'm just thinking this part here would be like such a bitch to do with Hawkeye, because Hawkeye can't grab onto the ledge there. Perfect. All right. So close to getting out of here. Careful. All right, now if you want, I could chance it. If you want, you can get hit. If you're at full life like I do right now, you can take a hit at the by one of these rockets here, and then just charge right through. But let's see if we can do without it. Perfect. Take our time here. We have the Quinchet. Oh, that is such a relief, guys. Let's have a water break. The reason the Quinchet is a relief is because if you die at any point now, as long as you have the Quinchet, you don't have to go back and do other stages that you've previously done already. You could just go straight to wherever you have to go to. With that said, let's make our way so you can go. You can just pass here. There you go. I don't have to do this stage. Go right to Avengers Park. Let's fight the Mandarin. Part with this guy now is I gotta jump over his fire when he turns into a fireball, because I need the full health to fight Mandarin. And the good news, if I beat the Mandarin, I don't have to fight these enemies ever again. These tedious ones. That's bullshit, come on. This is a waste. I should die right now. I need full life against Mandarin. Okay, so, like I said, I died, but the good news is, once we revive Captain America, he'll have the Quinchet, then we don't have to do anything like all those stages ever again. So that's good news. Oh god. I lost count. This guy is going to be Mandarin. Thank you. That's Mandarin. Alright, we're down to the end, guys. Is that a health? No. No. I think there's a health right here. Perfect. Oh crap. That's fine, whatever. Here's one ups. By the way, the one ups in the game are, they're continues. So yeah, you can get game over in this. And right here, like, it's really hard to do a Hawkeye-only run, because you have to go through here to beat the game, and in order to get up here, you need Captain America. So Cap-only is possible, Hawkeye-only is not. And there'll be no more lasers. So yeah, after you beat the Mandarin, all the power goes back to how it was when you first started the game. For the enemies, I mean. Their hit points drop down like you're facing them for the first time. But at this point, there's like no more enemies in the game. Just two bosses. So we have Crossbones again, and then we have another. Red Skull. So right here will be full health. Oh crap, that sucks. To use that health. That's not bad. I mean, I lost 2 bars of health, but would have loved to have full life for Red Skull. This guy is one of the hardest bosses on the NES, I think so. If you don't know what you're doing. I want to get him stuck in this loop, but sometimes he'll get out of it. Beat him with the little health that we had, and that is it, guys. So we struggled a little bit with Ultron. See, the thing with Ultron is that Ultron has a set pattern, where if you mess up anything, like the way I did it the last time is perfectly. If you ever are trying to do this challenge and are struggling with Ultron, and you're using Captain America, beat him. Do the same moves, the exact same moves I did on that run. If you mess up anything on that one, it's gonna be like he'll just change his whole pattern around after. That's what's so weird. Like I couldn't get it going, but I think like what, 3 or 4 attempts to beat him. But after we got hit by him, I was more worried about the gauntlet, I call it. The one where you fight Crossbones the first time. So you go through the stage, you fight Crossbones, then you fight the two other stages to get to the Quinchet. I was more worried about that, because if you die at any point there, you got to restart the whole thing again, and those enemies are just so tedious. Once you get the Quinchet, though, everything's a lot easier. You don't have to, you can skip all the previous battles. The Mandarin fight, that's not so bad. It's just like a gauntlet of guys, but like I showed you earlier, you have to get by him, you have to get to him with full life just to stand a chance against him. That's why once I took that hit, I'm like, you know what, let me just start again. And I didn't mind at that point because I had the Quinchet, I could just skip over everything. And yeah, we beat the Red Skull in one shot. That's pretty impressive, even without the full health. So that's it. To be continued. What are they trying to say? They want me to do this with Hawkeye? No. Doing this with Hawkeye would be the true challenge, because, like I said, Cap is just superior in every way. He's got 2 extra moves, and he's more powerful. I think Captain America's shield does more damage than Hawkeye's arrows, believe it or not. But Hawkeye, you can shoot in multiple directions, so he's got his own advantages as well. But Captain America can, you know, he's acrobatic, he can hang on to stuff, so that would be a tough challenge doing a Hawkeye only. I'll see about that in the future. But for now, guys, that does it for me, guys. Challenge complete. Thanks a lot for watching, guys. Hope you guys enjoyed. This is Captain Joe C. See you guys later.